I think I do what I do because I've always wanted to feel as if I had something to contribute to the conversation about God. And I've always felt that I do have something to contribute to that conversation. I guess this is a conversation that takes seriously the ways that people reach in and reach out to connect to the divine in their daily lives through community, through activism, through worship, through the word, and even in this academic capacity. I don't know that I always identified as a scholar, but I remember back before I entered into grade school, I was taught to read at Northside Baptist School in San Antonio, Texas by Miss Rodriguez. Miss Rodriguez taught me how to read. And when I learned how to read, I read books after books after books. And I think it was just kind of an ethic that I took into all the years of schooling that I've had. If somebody gives you a tool, you use it. You use it to become a sharpened thinker. You use it. I guess eventually the purpose became so you could contribute to these ongoing discourses. I would say that my vocation as a scholar is to, A, gain some more tools so that I can only give them back to other folks to use. In recent years, classroom seminar spaces, workshop spaces have increasingly become sacred spaces. Wherein I have been met by God in ways that I'm still trying to articulate. But in each space, I have been given a tool that I've been able to go back and use. And I think that that is something that's informing my scholarship, that at some point, eventually, all that I'm obtaining, I want to give it back to somebody. I want to expand a classroom into a sacred space. I want a woman to sit in my space and say, maybe I can pursue this. Maybe I can have this conversation and to be able to provide a model of how to do it. Just as we have been able to witness models here this weekend and throughout our network of FTE fellows and alumni and faculty. So it's, I think, a constant process of reaching forward to reach back.
Mm-hmm.